I am going to try to find all the zeros for this fifth degree function. Since we're finding all the zeros, that means we could include the complex values. If it had said find all the real values, then we're only finding those that we would see plotted on the xy plane. We know, due to the fundamental theorem of algebra, that we're going to have five values that should satisfy this equal to zero when we plug in an x. I'm going to go ahead and use synthetic division where I can to start out with. And as a starting place, I'm going to look for factors of 120 to try to divide into this. Since this is even, I'm going to start with a 2, and we want all of our coefficients. So we're just listing all of our coefficients. We do not have any x's that are missing. We start at 5 and we count down to 0, so we are good with that. Since this ends with a 0, we know that this is one of the x's that will work. If we plug x into here, the y value will be 0 according to the remainder theorem. I'm just going to make my next division bracket under here and try dividing into this. This is the depressed polynomial that we got from dividing out the x minus 2 from this. So we can continue dividing this. If it divides this, it divides this. Next, I'm going to try to divide 3. That's a divisor of 60. If you had tried 2 again, since this is an even number, you will find that the remainder is not 0, so we don't have another factor of 2 there to deal with, so we're going to try 3. These numbers are getting pretty big, so I don't think 3 is going to work here either. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to a negative 3, and maybe I needed to switch to a negative 2 also here. And we'll try this. We ended up with a 0 again here, which means that negative 3 does divide this, and this is the depressed polynomial from that division. We again have an even number, so I'm going to go ahead and try a negative 2 on this. You can see that I'm going to have 20 plus 4 is 24, which is, of course, not 0, so negative 2 is not on this. 2 is not going to work on this. We can try a 5 would be a factor, 20 is a factor, 1's a factor. We can see that 5, the number, continues to increase, so I'm going to switch this to a negative, and we'll try a negative. We can already see that the negative is going to be to our advantage there. And when we do the negative 5, we do end up with a 0 here, and we have 3 here. Now these three terms would be the a, the b, and the c for the quadratic formula. So we don't have to continue with this strategy of the synthetic division. We can now use the quadratic formula with these as the a, the b, and the c in the quadratic formula and find the last two terms that we need. So we found 2, negative 3, and negative 5 here. So let me write out to the side what these factors are. And now I'm going to erase this, and we're going to put the 104 into the quadratic formula. I have my A, B, and C substituted in here, and now we're just going to work through the simplification here. We have 0 on the outside, which is not going to change anything as we add or subtract here. We're going to multiply here and multiply in here. We see at this point that we're going to have to take the square root of a negative number, which is going to give us those complex values. X is going to be the positive 4i over 2, which reduces to 2i. And X will also be the negative version of that, so we'll have negative 2i. So we have 2, negative 3, negative 5, 2i, and negative 2i are the 5 x values that will give us a 0 for this function. Cheerful calculations.